You're listening to the Heavy Duty Parts Report. I'm your host, Jamie Irvin, and this is the show where you get expert advice about the heavy duty parts you buy and sell and keep you informed about what's happening in the industry. Welcome to the Heavy Duty Parts Report. I'm your host, Jamie Irvin. I'd like you to picture this. You're driving down the road, you're having a great day, listening to your favorite podcast, and all of a sudden you see a fault code on your dash. All of a sudden your whole day changes. You pull over, now what? In this episode, we're going to be announcing the launch to a solution to this problem, and we're going to be talking about a new product that's coming that we're very excited about. In order to introduce this new product, I'd like to introduce you to Brett Delp from Dorman Products and Tyler Robertson from Diesel Laptops. Gentlemen, welcome to the show. Brett, glad to have you here.
Glad to be here, Jamie. Excited to talk about a new Dorman solution and working with Tyler at Diesel Laptops.
Tyler, welcome back to the show.
You know, it's starting to feel like a second home on your podcast show. I love it. So thank you for inviting me back on.
You've got a couple of people competing for top spot as most times back on the show, but you're still leading the pack. So we're happy to have you here. Brett, when I looked at your bio, you started off as a diesel mechanic. You worked for Ryder and JB Hunt before joining Dorman in 2014, and you've kind of worked your way up at Dorman, and now you're working there for the last few years as a national fleet sales manager. So you've really had a perspective of both sides of the industry, and you really love the industry, don't you?
Yeah, I really do. You know, I was, you know, working with my dad at a young age on his truck and really just kind of fell in love with diesel applications and diesel vehicles and kind of problem solving, figuring out what's going on. So, you know, I kind of led down that path of going to Wyotech and got in at Ryder and, you know, kind of worked my way up there, learned from a lot of the guys in the industry, and then joining the Dorman team to use that background to kind of get into the parts side and the manufacturing side and figure out, you know, what are the problems that people are having out in the field from a technician standpoint, and how can Dorman solve them. So, you know, it's been a long time in this industry for me at a young age, but I really enjoy it and I really hope to be impactful as a lot of the guys are that I work with at TMC and other various industry functions. So I'm happy to be here.
Awesome. And Tyler, for those who aren't familiar, you're the CEO of Diesel Laptops. You've worked in the industry for a long time, over 20 years. You started off working in service and then in parts. And now you've been the CEO of Diesel Laptops 6 years today, actually, on the day of recording. And you've been had a real heavy focus on really repair efficiency and really supporting the independent diesel technician.
Yeah, well, I was in the trenches there for 10 years. So I was a service manager, I was a parts manager. I got to talk to a ton of truck drivers and business owners, and they all have problems, a lack of information, a lack of tools, a lack of knowledge. And it's really been our job to come forward and say, hey, let's try to fix that problem. So yeah, that 10 years of experience, especially the last 10 years, really led me to be able to come up with solutions and learn more about the industry.
So we kind of alluded to it, Tyler, at the opening of the show, but we're announcing this new product. It's called Diesel Decoder. What big problem are you trying to solve?
Yeah, for me, the problem I see a lot out there is people don't have a quick, easy way to tell what's wrong with their truck. And I know government regulation tried to help that by making onboard displays and things they have to put in the vehicle now to show fault codes. But of course, OEMs don't always show the right fault codes. They show some weirdness out there and nobody knows. And there was a report a couple of years back, and on an average day, there's like 2.5 warning indicator lights that come on during the day of a truck. And people just have questions. You can hang out in Facebook groups all day long. Owner operators, drivers, what's this code mean? What do I do? Is it serious? Do I need to pull over? Do I need to go somewhere? Nobody knows. So we're like, you know what the industry needs? Is they need a very quick, easy to use tool that will show them what's going on inside their vehicle on the computer and lead them to the repair information to fix that code all within a couple minutes. And I think that's the product we came up with.
And that's really the issue, isn't it? Like, you think of your own personal vehicle, that light comes on right away. You're worried about, you know, is this a serious thing? Should I be pulling over immediately? Can I get to a repair shop? Should I just ignore it? But then you add a commercial vehicle with all of that additional complexity and the fact that, for example, if something's wrong with your engine and you ignore it, it's a $50,000 or $60,000 bill. It's a big deal. So, Brett, how does Diesel Decoder actually work? Let's get into the actual details of how this thing works.
Yeah, absolutely. It's a very powerful diagnostic tool that connects to your handheld tablet, iPad device. So it's basically a diesel decoder is a dongle that connects to your 9-pin connector on vehicle or your OBD2 connector if you have Mac valve applications. Connects to all the popular models, year ranges, everything you need to get in. You connect, you have it upload via Bluetooth or Wi-Fi, connects to your mobile device, really lets you know what's going on with your vehicle from, everyday data logging, active and inactive fault codes. And it really empowers the driver or the mechanic, the shop repair guy to know what's going on with that vehicle as it's going down the road. So as that fault code comes up, he can take a look at his phone and say, okay, am I in a D-rate situation? Do I have 500 miles to go? What is going on with my vehicle and where do I need to be right now to take care of it?
Right. That makes sense to me. So it connects directly to the truck and then it connects to your mobile device via Bluetooth. Is that what I understood?
Yep, either via Bluetooth or Wi-Fi. So both ways, and you can connect right to your phone and have live data, live feed to what's going on the vehicle.
Right, and so this is actually an application that you have to like download on your device first, and then you connect everything. Is that how it works?
Yep, there's a free Diesel Decoder app for Apple and Android. You can get it on the marketplace. You log in, create an account, put your information in, and you can connect to the dongle and connect to the vehicle fairly simply.
Okay. And the launch date for this product, like when will people be able to expect to start to be able to take advantage of this product?
Right now, we're looking at an April 1 launch date. So it should be available very soon, and we're excited to get it out in the market.
Okay, fantastic. So Tyler, one thing I'm kind of interested in is like it's great to be able to see these codes. But how does this empower the owner operator or the driver to make better decisions?
So not only will this tool hook up and tell you the fault codes that you have going on, but users can one tap and immediately go over to the diesel repair website and they can view quick repair information. So essentially within 3 minutes, you can be connected, reading your vehicle information, viewing that specific fault code along with the probable causes. And that's just the start of it. So in the very beginning, it goes back to what we do here. Let's make this way more transparent, way easier for people to solve their problems. And that's what we're really looking to do with this tool. So it's a great tool to get you to that quick repair in a matter of minutes.
Yeah, and I can see how that would be very important, especially if you're in a down situation where you felt you needed to pull over and you're not really sure what's going on and you just want to know, what's the next step, right? Should I call a tow? Can I get to that repair shop? I mean, that information can really be the difference between making money or losing a lot of money.
Absolutely. I mean, we sell $10,000 tools that can't do that in that short of a time. So this to us is a real groundbreaker tool because now everybody has the power in their phone already. Now you're buying a really inexpensive tool. This isn't a $1,000 tool that we're talking about here with Dorman. This is a very entry-level, inexpensive tool that will allow people to do this seamlessly, quickly, easily, and efficiently, which we think will save people time and money in the long run.
Yeah, so it's really designed for everybody so that everybody can get access to it. We're going to talk more about that right after our break. We'll be right back. I just wanted to take a brief moment to let you know that I've been working with forward-thinking, heavy-duty companies as a business consultant. Creating great content, helping sales use digital tools more effectively, and developing business growth strategies are the most common projects that I'm involved in. If you would like to work with me, go to heavydutypartsreport.com/consultant. That's heavydutypartsreport.com/consultant to learn more. I also work as a brand ambassador for great brands like Diesel Parts. Diesel Parts is a aftermarket parts cross-reference and lookup tool that makes it easier to identify parts than ever before. Go to parts.diesellaptops.com to create your free account. That's parts.diesellaptops.com. All right, let's get back to the interview. Okay, we're back from our break, and we've been talking about the launch of this new product called Diesel Decoder. It's going to be available through Dorman Products. It's powered by Diesel Laptops. We've got Brett and Tyler here talking to us about that today. Tyler, what role does Diesel Decoder play? Kind of what future role will it play in predictive maintenance? What things in the future will people be able to do with it?
Yeah, so this is kind of like version one of this tool, right? A quick tool, give you repair information, which in itself is amazing. What's coming soon will be the ability inside that app on the phone to turn on predictive analytics or predictive maintenance. So essentially, there's things going on in your vehicle before fault codes occur, and we'll be using that technology, and we'll be allowing people to actually know before there's a problem. And not only that, we plan to do a lot of other things with it. There'll be a dashboard very soon where you can monitor as a fleet manager all your trucks that are out in the market, or as a repair shop, all your scans that are going on. So that truck can be 1,000 miles away. You'll have a vehicle health report dashboard that you can display that information on. We have a couple partners that have teamed up with us. So I'm happy to announce that both SOAR and LightCheck will both be using our hardware to make their own application as well. So now this one Diesel Decoder device will actually have multiple applications with different companies, which is great because now you have the same hardware platform, different software, makes it a great ecosystem for everything that's going on. And of course, it wouldn't be a diagnostic tool if we didn't add bidirectional commands. So you can really soon expect to see common bidirectional commands, DPF resets, DPF cleaning, parameter changes for max road speed. All these things are coming along as we develop them and start releasing them.
And Brett, when I think about the work that your company and along with partnership with Diesel Laptops is doing to really empower that end user, the person who is going to end up having to use this to their benefit, I think immediately of the aftermarket. You know, we have independent repair shops, we've got fleets doing their own maintenance. What role does Diesel Decoder kind of play in making their world a better place? Because it's not just for the owner-operator, is it?
No, it's not just for the owner-operator. It's for, you know, the fleet and the driver to have the power to know what's going on with their vehicle and how much time they have and where do they have to get to, right? So, you know, as the fault code comes live, they take a look at it, see what's going on. Okay, this needs to be repaired immediately. Okay, where do I have to go? What part do I need? You know, utilizing, like Tyler said, the repair information, that stuff is vital to them. So, you know, if the owner operator is going down the road or a fleet driver is going down the road, he sees the fault code come on, says, okay, I can go 500 miles. I can wait and report back to the shop or call my parts manager and say, hey, here's the part I need. Here's what I'm looking at. Can you get this ordered and scheduled the next time I come in for service? Or if it's truck down situation, you know, you're calling your local parts distributor or parts repair facility and saying, hey, here's what I'm looking at. Can you help me, you know, get to the point, replace this part and get me back on the road as quick as possible? And ultimately avoid, you know, downtime, avoid a tow, if you will, and those added costs that just eat at your margin.
So what Brett's alluding to there is the part I didn't really touch on. It's the fact that because we have this great diesel parts platform, we know what parts it takes to go on which trucks. And now we have our fault codes and we know which components, they're being merged together. So what we're essentially telling people here is this tool, it won't be today, but it'll be tomorrow in the near future, not only to show you the possible causes of that fault code, but the actual OEM number and the aftermarket alternatives for that number to fix that fault code, which in itself has never been done in our industry. We call it from fault to fix. So we're pretty excited about that.
Right. And so I'm kind of thinking of how this will actually help the, like a parts reseller, for example. So one of Dorman's distributors. So someone pulls up, they've got a fault code. They go into the parts counter. The partsman will have one. They can run out, quickly identify what it is, sell that person the part, and oh, by the way, sell them a Diesel Decoder so they can throw it in the dash and they've got it for next time. So this is not something that's really going to take away from the aftermarket or the independent. It's actually going to support them. Do I understand that correctly, guys?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, ultimately, a lot of times you look at after treatment, for example, one of the top spends for fleets right now, and a majority of that is going back to the dealer. But if you're able to utilize this tool, whether it is pulling into an independent aftermarket parts distributor and getting it diagnosed, or you already have the Diesel Decoder and you know, hey, you know, this is the distributor I got it from. They have the parts on the shelf that I need. Ultimately, if you're going to take some of that market share back from the OE and bring it into the independent aftermarket.
Yeah. And Tyler, you and I have done a lot of work together talking to the industry about how things are rapidly changing and how data and technology needs to be really in, incorporated into the way that the independent does business. So from your perspective, how does this help the aftermarket and the independent?
Well, to me, this flips the script because everyone's used to the customer calling with their problem. Now the customer can call with a solution and say, hey, I need this part number. And it really, I think we've talked about it a lot on your other segments, and I've talked about it a lot in my podcast. The industry's changing. Technology's changing it. It's no longer these parts people need to have all this knowledge. Yeah, they need to have that stuff, but customers are starting to get access to that information now as well. And it totally just flips the script on how business is handled. So I think it's a real game changer. And I think people will start to see, I get it now. I get what they've been talking about for the last 2 years. I see it. And this is just step one of 100 in the direction it's going. And I really think distributors need to get on board and really figure out a lot of their own business model, knowing the way the world's changing. And to me, the doors are pretty clear and the avenues are clear and the path is clear. I don't know if it is to them yet, but I'm hoping they'll start opening their eyes to it a little bit more.
Yeah. And so my encouragement is, if you've got a few hundred stores, I think you should be talking to Dorman about buying a few hundred of these and putting them, you know, at least a couple on every parts counter, because this is going to be a great opportunity. So Brett, April 1st, it's going to be available. Where's the best place for people to go to learn more? Do you have like a website URL people can check it out on?
Yeah. So DormanHDSolutions.com. We're going to have some training up there with, you know, different videos from just a connectivity standpoint and different modules all the way down to getting into the fault codes, and then ultimately getting from fault code to fix, as Tyler said. So DormanHDSolutions.com is the best place to go and learn about that today.
Okay, fantastic. So we'll make sure that there is a link in the show notes so people can go and check it out and just link right over to your site. I really appreciate you coming on, and I think the work that Dorman is doing to really support the aftermarket is fantastic. So Brett, thank you for being a guest on the show today.
Yeah, absolutely. Jamie, thank you for having me.
And Tyler, you're tirelessly working to improve and support the independent repair locations to really support the aftermarket parts distribution side of the industry. I think that work that you're doing is so important. And as always, I really appreciate you being on the show.
I appreciate it coming on here, Jamie. And this product we've been working on for years, thousands and thousands of man owners. We found a great partner with Dorman. They have great distribution. They have the same vision we do. They understand the industry like we understand it. So we're really excited to get this thing going. We think it's going to be a big deal in our industry.
Awesome. Thank you so much. We'll talk to you guys again very, very soon. My name is Jamie Irvin. I'm the host of the Heavy Duty Parts Report. And if you'd like to check out all of our content, go to heavydutypartsreport.com. You'll be able to find this episode and many, many more. And as I said, I'll make sure to include a link in the show notes so that if you'd like to buy a diesel decoder, you'll be able to find out where you can go to buy them. Thank you so much, and we'll talk to you soon. Thank you so much for tuning in to this week's episode of the Heavy Duty Parts Report. I'm your host, Jamie Irvin, and I just like to remind everyone to focus on cost per mile and let's keep those trucks and trailers rolling. You can watch our next video. Make sure to click the like button, write a comment, and don't forget to subscribe.